Let's introduce, yeah, by talking about all the hands-on, how to using ARKit in Unity and how they implemented it in this new AI Foundation workflow. My name is Kai Notrot. I am from Accenture. I'm a developer for extended reality. And I think most of you have seen the WWDC, which ARKit 3 was introduced. I'm sure that I not can show you all the new features in this talk. So, but we take focus on motion capturing, object tracking, and people occlusion. For this, we have built a project for the zoo and the digital tag in Zurich. There was some ideas to use, can we do something with ARKit 3, and something was enhance the zoo. And I show you a small video how the demo was running at the end. So yeah, this was two demos seen in this video. So the first one was the three pillars with different animals. And the idea behind that was, you have often in the zoos description walls with all the information about the animals, but most of the people don't read it and only walk around. Or you have some other ideas to show something what you cannot show with a real animal. And for this, we have built three pillars with different animals and object tracking to recognize which pillars is which animal. And you have to take your iPad, go to the pillar, and this diorama of the animal appears. And there are some info points, like here. You can touch on it and get some information about when you see the left info point, it shows you how many spines a giraffe has. And when you pull up the device, you got in a 360 video of the real atmosphere of the animal. Yeah, to implement this, we have used, it's not real at ARKit 3 features, was already inside of ARKit 2, but it was most improved in ARKit 3. And for this, we used object tracking. And now I want to show you how you can implement this in Unity. So first of all, you have to install the package manager. From the package manager, the AR Foundation. And I hope most of you know that most of the tools are now inside of the package manager and not anymore in the asset store. And additional to that, ARKit was a repository you have to clone into your project before. So now you have it really easy. Open the package manager, install AR Foundation, and say ARXR plugin. Or when you want to use something cross-platforming, install also AR Core. So AR Foundation handled both of these systems. So going back to the presentation short. At first, we need an object we want to track. And on iOS, Apple provides you with a scanning app to scan an object and get an object file, which you can use for object tracking. I have a wonderful candle here I found on my desk, which I take an example for tracking. And you start this tracking app, and you must put the bounding box around the object. Then you can start the tracking. You must track it from all the sides and shows you how your scan percentage is. This takes some time. And yeah, you see when you have a cable on this, it's also glitching. So, and when this is finished, you can test how good it works. So, kind of working. And then you can share it over AirDrop over to your laptop and put it in your project. So, go back to Unity. And here you can see this is a file of the candle. So, the next step is only you have to delete the real camera and create a new XRIR session origin, which gives you a game object with all the capabilities to use ARKit 3. It's automatically change the camera system. You can make the focus, fix, and auto, light estimation, all the stuff you need. You can also change the culling material in the background. And that's everything you have to set up at first. Additional to that, you need for the input an AR session. But that's it for the basic setup in the AR Foundation workflow. So when we want to track some objects, we need to add to the AR session and component. It starts with AR. And then we have the AR tracked object manager. So here you can see you need an XR reference object library and a tracked object prefab. So at first we want only to show this large axis if the object recognition was successful. And additional to that, we must create the reference library. For this, you must only go in your project folder, go to XR, and here you have the reference object library. It's the same procedure you use for image recognition. So we have this library, add a new object, name it candle, and drag and drop the object in. And that's it. The last one, you must put in the library to your AR object track manager. If you need some information from your object, which is generated when you have tracked the object, there's also the AR tracked object. This gives you the name and some additional information you need when you want to build some further steps. So let's see how this application will work. I have already built it on this phone. And see only my phone. And when you're now searching for this candle, he recognized the object. So, and that's basically all you need to implement object tracking in Unity with AR Foundation. Go back. So another was we have implemented a jumping station. And for this, we need motion tracking. This is how it looks like in Clojure. So the idea was that the children who are coming to this fair can make a jump session to beat these animals on the blank. So the first one was a chicken, the second one was a zebra, and a lion and an antelope. And in this demo, we included two features from ARKit 2, where you have seen that the guy is presenting like a human segmentation in this 3D environment. But start with the tracking of the human. So in ARKit 3, they give you a lot of joints you can automatically recognize and give it in this naming convention. That's the main thing you must think about. There is a list you can see on the developer side how the naming of the bones are written, and you must only update your skeleton to this naming, but it's really a normal naming. So let's take a look how this works. For this, open new scene, but it's really again the same project. You delete the camera. I make it now a little bit faster. Enter a session object and enter things. So then again, we need a human body tracker manager. And here you have different objects. So ARKit automatically offers you different types of recognizing humans. And the easiest one is a 2D. It's traditional line render. You get some simple bones. Then you have the 3D estimation that gives you the full body in a 3D object world. And you also can track the scale, because all of you have different heights. And when you want to have the 3D object estimate or react on your height, this was also a problem in this demo, that it's now implemented. And the other parts we make later. And in this case, we can also create a new game object and call it human tracker. And root it to zero and add a human body tracker. And here we must give, again, like in the object tracking mode, we also give them a prefab we want to generate when the tracking was successful. And also the human body manager. So in this case, we only need to tell our 3D object that he has to apply to the movement of the body. So you must tell the animation controller what he has to do. And for this, there's also a script provided from Unity. It's a bone controller which only matches the joints to the animator. So let's see how this works. So, someone in this room who wants to make some sports or want to make some movements here? No? So you will see it will automatically track the human and also his movements. And in our demo, we have recognized the spine of the human for the tracking of the height, how high he's jumping. Yeah. And you can see it's really precise, also in this bad light conditions.
Chicken jumping?
Yeah. A chicken jumps 1 meter. That's an iPhone XS. So it works with all iPhones which have an A12 chip. But when you see when I go into the, he doesn't know which human he must take. So, yeah. So, and that's it. So, rip. So when we go back to people occlusion, I think most of you know this this problem. second. So when you have an AR object and you make your hand in front of it, it will disturb the immersive feeling. And for this, Apple introduced the pupil occlusion functionality that you can, with an AI, recognize this is something what looks like a human. And it gives you the depths and the textures to make sure that the hand is before the object and not behind the object. And let's take a look how to implement this. The main problem is, okay, you have an object you want to show in AR, but you have people in front and back. And the device gives you this segmentation and depth image, and with this you can provide what you want. And to implement this, you have to do all the same steps we have currently for this human body tracking. It's only that you have here the stencil mode. You can choose the resolution and the depth mode. And when you have both of these features on, you can get access to the stencil and segmentation map. Let's take a look how an application could be look like to show how the maps are working. There's also an example scene. I have duplicated it. And here you can see now. So it's a really simple application. We have a canvas, only two images, and in these two images, I render the stencil and the depth map, and you will see soon how it looks like. So go back to the phone. Go here. So, human segmentation. So what you here can see is different images. And the first one is a stencil map, and the second one is a depth map, which you can see have, I don't know if you can see it on the beamer, really, that this have a grayscale depth image feeling. But also recognize that many humans in there front of me. And this technique is what we have used to make this green screen effect for the jumping station. So I take this stencil map, build a small mask shader, and put it on a layer and put this human in the terrain of the animals. You can see here again. And you see, it's not really precise, and when the guy is jumping, it will not recognize perfectly. But the effect is really cool when you make this on a fair and they see, oh, there's no green screen behind me. Yeah. So, there was one problem was happening during this project. We have built the terrain and the mask shader and tested separately, and the tracking has done another colleague for me. And then we recognized, oh, you can't use both features at the same time. And it was 1 week before presentation. And then the problem was starting, and okay, the end result was we have take two Apple devices and print this holder for the second phone, put it together and shown that we can get the human tracking from the iPhone, send it to the iPad, and make the plank moving. Yeah. And that's how it works in Unity with the Racket 3.